Gene expression vectors are an important tool in life science research. Most conventional vectors are used to constitutively express a transgene of interest, meaning that the researcher will have little to no control over the duration or level of expression of the gene. However, such uncontrolled expression may cause cell death when studying toxic genes or genes which are not well tolerated by the cell. Thus, inducible expression can be useful to determine a clear genetic basis for a phenotype by observing the phenotype appearing and disappearing as transcription is turned on or off. For these cases, it is useful to use a gene expression vector with a promoter that only becomes active once a given compound is added. A number of inducible systems have been developed for use in mammalian cells, including regulation by steroid hormones, heavy metals, heat shock, and tetracycline. One limitation of these systems is the leakiness, or background expression, that sometimes occurs in the off state. Another problem is that the inducers may cause unwanted effects of their own, which can cause cytotoxicity or confound data about transgene expression. To combat these problems, scientists at the National Research Council of Canada have developed the Cumate Inducible system. As the name suggests, the inducing element for this system is cumate, a small, non-toxic molecule that can be added directly to the culture medium. Cumate is an excellent inducer since it has no significant effect on a cell's protein expression, is inexpensive, and is not found in commonly used cell culture reagents. How does the Cumate inducible system work? There are three elements involved: the Cumate operator sequence, also known as CUO, the SIMR repressor, and the inducer itself, Cumate. The Cumate operator sequence is found downstream of a promoter and upstream of the transgene. When Cumate is not present, SIMR binds with high affinity to the Cumate operator sequence and blocks transcription of the transgene, leaving the system in an off state. However, as soon as Cumate is added, it associates with SIMR and prevents it from binding to the Cumate operator. This switches the system on and allows transcription to proceed unhindered. Level of gene expression can be fine-tuned by adding greater or lesser amounts of Cumate. For example, it's easy to see here that the level of GFP reporter expression increases when more Cumate is added to the media. It's also easy to turn the system off again, simply by performing a quick and easy media change to remove the Cumate. The system may be turned on and off at will, as many times as desired. ABM's Cumate-inducible lentiviral vectors use a CMV promoter, as it leads to strong gene expression and is active in a broad range of mammalian cells. Our system is optimized for a dual vector format, where the SIMR repressor is provided in one vector and the Cumate-inducible gene of interest is in another. The dual vector format allows large inserts to be packaged and ensures tight regulation of gene expression. Our Cumate-inducible cloning vectors are available with or without constitutive or inducible reporter gene expression. Constitutive GFP or RFP expression that is not controlled by Cumate may be useful for monitoring transfection efficiency and facilitating stable cell line generation. Inducible reporter expression is useful for monitoring the efficiency of induction and relative gene expression. We also offer pre-made Cumate-inducible lentiviral vectors and viruses for expression of any human, mouse, or rat gene, or any miRNA from our extensive clone collection. The SIMR repressor can be expressed using one of our SIMR repressor vectors, or, for more convenience, you can use our pre-made SIMR-expressing stable cell lines. In conclusion, inducible gene expression is useful for studying a gene which would be deleterious when constitutively expressed, and determining a clear cause and effect relationship between genotype and phenotype. The Cumate inducible system offers the following advantages over other inducible systems. Number one, tight regulation of gene expression with extremely low background expression levels. It has very little leakage compared to similar systems. Number two, it's easy to adjust the level of gene expression by adjusting Cumate concentration, The relationship between concentration and expression is linear and titratable. Number 3. Gene expression is reversible and may be turned on and off as many times as required. And number 4, no special media or conditions are required during cell culture. At ABM, we offer everything you need to perform your own Cumate Inducible expression experiment. If you're interested, click the link in the description. And if you enjoyed watching this video, check out our other video series and subscribe to get the latest updates. Thanks for watching!